Traveling is one of the best things you can do with your partner. You get to go to the unknown places, experience the new cultures, explore the new landscapes. Also, it's the best way to learn about yourself as well as your partner.
We've been traveling together to more than 30 countries in the past 8 years and married for more than half of that time. So we'd like to share with you our tips that might help when you travel with your partner.
Also, this is our first time to make the video in English, so please bear with us. Hi, my name is Pak.
I'm Prich.
We are a Thai couple living in Bangkok, Thailand, and we love traveling and photography.
If you'd like to see more tips and tricks about travel and photography, please subscribe.
Well, we have been traveling around the world for more than 30 countries in the past decade, and we have been married for more than 4 years.
So in this video, we are sharing with you 5 tips that will make your traveling with your partner more pleasant and enjoyable. Before we dive into the tips, we'll tell you some background story about us. We first met in the UK in 2012, which is 8 years ago. Then we spent 1 year in the UK, and after we graduated, we decided to go back home in Thailand from the UK by train, by the Trans-Siberian Railway.
Everyone thought that we were quite a bit crazy because it's like a big journey to take at that point of time, because back then when we started traveling, we had been dating for just
almost a year, probably.
It was quite a big step because when we traveled, we had to spend time together 24 hours in a day.
And back at that time, it was our experience to learn to live with each other.
Yeah. And to explore what we liked or what we didn't like, and we had to figure it out. Otherwise, the trip was going to be quite miserable if we fight all the time.
Right. And later on, when we got back to our home, Thailand, we got married. And after that, we even took an even more adventurous journey. Mm-hmm. We went to
South America for 4 months together, and then
Nepal.
And we went trekking in Nepal and Pakistan, and went to like really rough places on earth.
But actually these trips just brought us more closer. Yeah.
And believe it or not, we barely fight at all.
So here are the tips that we learned from the past experiences.
Number one, listening is key. Listening is one of the most important skills that you have to have when you are in a relationship, because it's the one that helps you understand the other. You have to listen with an intent to understand. Not an intent to argue, not an intent to fight, not an intent to defend yourself. You just have to listen to understand. Listen with empathy. Listen without your judgment. Listen without bias. And I know it is very difficult to do. When I started practicing this, it is really difficult to exclude myself out of the conversation and just concentrate on what the other person is saying. But if you can do this, it will really help you, because if you can really understand what the other say, it just makes everything a lot easier.
Tip number two, identify your feeling. Identifying your feelings is the key to understanding. In the society nowadays, I see that there's a lot of people who like to hide their feelings, especially negative feelings. And when they suppress their feeling for a long time, they might have emotional numbness. And for me, when I started dating back then, I couldn't really express my emotion or my feeling or even my thought, because I didn't learn how to express or extract the feeling that I actually feel. So I know that there's something wrong with me, but I couldn't really say it out loud. I think it is really important to know feeling and emotion, and you could identify it and tell your partner. And I think this really helps your relationship and also let your partner know about you and understand you more.
Tip number three, take care of yourself. Don't expect your partner to always take care of you, because it's not realistic and it will make you miserable. I know that some couples, or most couples, rely on their partner to take care of them, or they expect their partner to take care of them. But the truth is, we should be able to take care of ourselves first, and you should be really responsible for yourself. If you can do this, it will lower your expectation and you'll be a lot happier.
Tip number four, be equal. I think everyone should be equal in their relationship, because it's the way to make it work. And I think it's the fairest way to treat other people. I don't think we should conform the social norm because I don't think that men should always take care of the women. For me, I see him as a human being. I don't see him as a guy. I mean, I feel like we are equal. I treat him as a human being because I feel like he doesn't have to always please me or treat me as a princess at all time. So for example, when we're traveling and we have our own luggages, but actually he doesn't have to take care of my luggage if I could do it all by myself. So I think we should lower our expectation from the social norm of how we should be treated or how we should treat other people, because the only good way to treat others is to treat them equally as if you want to treat yourself.
Tip number 5, embrace everything. You don't only embrace the positive experiences, you have to embrace the negative ones as well, especially the negative ones. When you embrace the negative experiences, the problems that you have will become more like a challenge that you have to overcome. It's just another thing in your path that you have to cross over. For example, when you are traveling and you miss the flight, the weather is bad, or whatever crazy things that might happen when you travel. If you don't embrace the negative experiences that you are having when you travel, it's gonna become more like a frustration. And the crazy thing is, if you embrace it, you don't feel frustrated anymore. That really helps, especially when you travel together with your partner, because when you feel frustrated, the other definitely can tell and it's gonna spiral downward really quickly. So we want you to embrace whatever it is in your experience, and it's gonna be okay.
There you have it. 5 tips to make your couple life better wherever you go.
If you like this video, don't forget to hit like and subscribe. And by the way, this is our first video in English. If we, probably it might not be as smooth as we thought it would be, but I think it's gonna be helpful for most of you. If you find this interesting and if you want to follow us, just hit the like and subscribe, and see you in the next video.